When trauma occurs to the spinal cord that causes a permanent neurological deficit, like loss of sensation or strength, nerve cells will die to some degree within the spinal cord or will function less than optimally, and a patient develops a degree of paralysis. Over time, scarring will typically occur in the spinal fluid space around the injured spinal cord, commonly from blood products. This scarring can be fine web-like bands between the spinal cord and covering of the spinal cord called the dura, can be thick and vascular or anywhere in between. The scarring places the spinal cord on a bit more tension than it was prior to the injury, causing it to lose some of its elasticity. The scarring can also block the normal flow of spinal fluid in the spinal fluid space. We call this scarring between the spinal cord and its covering called the dura tethering, because the spinal cord becomes held or tethered to the surrounding dura. In sum, the tension this scarring places on the spinal cord and nerve roots, along with the impaired spinal fluid flow around the spinal cord, can cause further injury to the spinal cord with symptoms of lost sensory and motor function, worsening spasticity, autonomic dysreflexia, abnormal sweating, known as hyperhidrosis, and neuropathic pain. In some patients, the scarring and tethering can make the spinal cord tissue get soft and leaky, allowing spinal fluid to enter the spinal cord tissue and even form tiny cyst cavities. This is called myelomalacia. These cavities can start small and then continue to increase in size within the spinal cord tissue. The symptoms experienced if a patient has predominantly spinal cord tethering or spinal cord tethering with a cyst, also known as a syrinx, are the same.